Hi, this is HJ. Welcome to the third video of the Unity UI Toolkit Beginner's Guide. In this video, I'll cover four topics. The first is how to automatically play a transition animation when a scene starts. The second is how to make an infinite looping animation. The third is how to create a typewriter effect using the DOTween. And finally, for fourth, I will explain how to hide the bottom after the transition animation is finished. I left this problem unsolved in the last video. Transition animations occur when properties values are different between two states. For example, I have a visual element with dark gray color. I prepared a state or style with different color. If the style is added to the visual element, its color changes instantly. However, if the visual element has non-zero duration value for its transition, the color difference is interpolated for the duration. This boy will be animated using the transition animation. I'll make two states or styles, one on the ground, the other in the air. Then I'll remove the in-the-air style when the scene starts. If I set duration and easing properly, the boy will be nicely animated without great difficulty. Go back to the UI builder. First, make the current state a style. As I pointed out, the key property which enables animation is the duration. Set the duration to 2 seconds and easing to ease out cubic. Extract it to a new style. Move the boy to make the other state. I'll use the translate property instead of position, because the visual element's going to be animated. Put minus 500 and minus 400 for translate X and Y. The boy is in the air and out of the screen. Make a new style. Preview the animation. In the style class list, delete the in the air class. The animation plays as we expected. Let's move on to the script. Declare a variable for the boy. In the start method, search the boy using uQuery and store it in the variable. Instead of writing the animation code here, I'll make a method separately. In the method animating the boy, I delete the in the air class using a remove from the class list. Let's see the animation. The animation doesn't play. The boy is already on the ground from the start. We need debugging to find out what's happened. In the last video, I shouldn't have deleted the update function, which is called every frame. I'll examine whether the in the air class is removed indeed. Now that I use the update, the state will be monitored frame by frame. There is a method perfect for this situation. It's the class list contains method. This method returns whether a visual element has a certain class in the list. Behind the boy variable, write the method. Put the class name we want to check in the parentheses. Play the scene briefly and go to the console window. A lot of logs are generated. False means the in the air class is not in the list. Go to the first message. It's also false. It means in the air state wasn't there from the start and no change in the states. If you look at the Unity documentation, this problem is mentioned. Let's get around this first frame issue by using the invoke method. With the invoke, we can delay when to call a method. 0.1 seconds seems okay. Play the scene. Now the animation is working fine. The logs actually changed from true to false at a certain point. I delayed the starting by an approximate time. However, if you use coroutines, it will be possible to skip the very first frame. So far, we've seen how to automatically play an animation when the scene starts. Next, let's take a look at how to create a looping animation. The girl in the bottom sheet is supposed to move up and down over and over again. It's a looping animation. As before, we need two different states. In the present state, only set the duration to 1 second. Extract it to a new style, and then make the up state. In the transform, set the translate y to minus 50. Extract it to a new class. I'll explain to you my plan. My basic strategy is adding and removing styles. When you add a style with a different translate Y value, the girl will go up or down. When the style is removed, the girl will be back to where she was. When I repeat the process, the animation will be looped infinitely. It sounds quite simple at first. In fact, it's not that simple at all, because there are two problems to be dealt with. The first problem is when to add or remove the styles. We need the exact moment when each transition ends in order to change the state. Even if we know when, another problem remains. We have to distinguish whether it's time to add or remove. If a style is added to the visual element which already has the style, no transition will occur. We've got the time issue and the state issue. Let's handle the time issue first. In a transition animations, there are key moments. The moment when the transition occurs, the moment when the animation starts to play after delay, and the moment when the animation ends. Unity offers a couple of transition events. With the transition end event, I can grab the moment when to start transition animations. Next is the state issue. The first thing that comes to mind is the class listContains method. We used it for debugging earlier. It sounds reasonable enough to check if a class is in the list with this method. However, there is a much more well-suited solution. It's the toggle in class list method. Basically, it adds or removes a style. What makes this method special is that it can distinguish when to add or remove. If the element doesn't have the style, it adds the style. On the other hand, if the element already has the style, it removes the style. You don't have to worry about no transitions by double adding. Whenever you call the method, the state is safely reversed. Declare a variable for the girl and get reference to it using the uQuery. Go to the method that opens the bottom sheet. I'll write the method outside. Call the method beforehand. Behind the girl variable, write toggle in class list. And in the parentheses, put the class name we will add or remove. I copy the name from the style sheet. Next, tell it what to do when the transition animation ends. It's the same register callback method used for the bottom sheet. The difference is the event type. This time, it's the transition end event. In the parentheses, put the another callback method name. It'll be called when the first transition ends. Its job is to revert the state again. Two callback methods will call each other, changing the state over and over again. Just copy the code from the above method. Since it knows when to add or remove, no more code is required. Play the scene. The animation plays and is looped flawlessly. I made the callback method separately for explanation. I'll clean up the code a bit and wrap it up. The next topic is the typewriter effect. There's a label below the girl. I'd like this label to come out letter by letter as other games show dialogues. I'll use the method that animates the girl. Keep the string to be printed out there. Declare a variable for the label and get a reference to the label. I used to make typewriter effects using DOTween. Fortunately, it is still available in the UI toolkit. A new namespace is required to take advantage of the DOTween. When the bottom sheet comes up, the label shows no text. The string assigned to the text property is printed out in the UI toolkit. String empty makes the label show no text. Make a new string type variable and assign the prepared string. Let the DOTween make the animation from the empty string to the complete one. After the getter and setter, put the target value, that is the complete string. And then set duration to 3 seconds and easing to linear. Typewriting effects with easing curves usually look strange. When the bottom sheet is up, the typewriter effect starts. Everything works as expected. As you probably noticed, using DOTween in the UI toolkit is somewhat cumbersome, because only the generic tweener is available. In UGUI, I can use the DOTween Pro as well as DOTween shortcuts. Now there is only one problem left. When the bottom sheet went down, its display was set to none before the transition animation started. Now we know the transition end event. With this event, it seems possible to set display after the animation ends. In the start method, let's register a callback method for the transition end event. At the bottom, write the callback method. What it does is just to hide the whole group. Cut the code and paste it here. Contrary to expectations, it got even worse. The reason lies with the transition end event. Actually, there are two transitions, one for up and the other for down. Events are generated from both occasions. What's needed here is the event that is generated when the down transition ends. The class list contains method can filter out the down transition. Let's examine the transitions closely. When the bottom sheet starts to come up, the up class is in the list. On the other hand, when it goes down, the list is empty. That's the condition for filtering out the event. Add an if statement before hiding the bottom sheet group. Now that we check if it's empty, negate the condition with an exclamation mark. Let's check. Finally, all the transition animations play as initially designed. This tutorial series has focused on the basics of the UI toolkit. The code is somewhat left unorganized. I recommend that you refer to the good materials and organize this part yourself. Unity has ambitiously aimed to replace the UG UI with the UI toolkit. However, it still has a long way to go. Let's take a look at how the UI toolkit will develop in the future. That's all for this video. If you visit my channel, you can see other interesting Unity-related works, especially UG UI animation and effects works. Thank you for watching.